Welcome to the Great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael, I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic is Mount Zion, the rapture, and 2 Esdras chapter 13. This is a confirmation of everything what we are teaching, a confirmation that our Lord and Savior will come down to Mount Zion to collect the remnant church into the rapture. Everything what we are teaching is confirmed through 2 Esdras chapter 13. Have you ever considered to walk that path to Mount Zion, to be part of the multitude clothed in white, and to be part in the rapture, and to be with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and his Father forever and ever? Walk with us together. Become a member of triple-grace.com. Watch the videos in our YouTube channel. Get an understanding of how you can come together in love, unity and support into these last times until the sixth seal. And this time period, we have to gather the saints. We have to gather the people into righteousness and bring them forth to Mount Zion. Now let us continue with 2 Esdras and to see what is written there as a confirmation to our teaching about Mount Zion. So let me switch over. Yes, so 2 Esdras 31. And one shall undertake to fight against another, one city against another, one place against another, one people against another, and one realm against another. This is the second seal, war, that everybody is fighting against one another. And the time shall be when these things shall come to pass, and the signs shall happen which I showed you before, and then shall my Son be declared, whom you saw as a man ascending. And when all the people hear his voice, every man shall in their own land leave the battle they have one against another, and an innumerable multitude shall be gathered together as you saw them, willing to come and to overcome him by fighting. But he shall stand upon the top of Mount Zion, and Zion shall come and shall be shewed to all men. This is the coming of the mountain not carved by human hands. Listen again, and Zion shall come and shall be showed to all men, sixth seal, being prepared and builded, like as you saw the hill graven without hands, a mountain carved without hands. This is Mount Zion. And this, my Son, shall rebuke the wicked inventions of those nations, which for their wicked life are fallen into the tempest. This is the time at the sixth seal when the people are start to hide into the caves and they want to stand against the Lamb that comes for his wrath and for the one who sits on the throne, and shall lay before them their evil thoughts and the torments wherewith they shall begin to be tormented, which are like unto a flame. And he shall destroy them without labor by the law which is like unto me. This is now the wrath of the Lamb coming. This will be the trumpet period. And whereas you saw it, that he gathered another peaceable multitude to him, the great multitude clothed in white, another peaceable multitude unto him. Those are the 10 tribes, this one who have dispersed, which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Salmanasar the king of Assyria led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land. Yes, they came everywhere. They were distributed to the whole world, and this is now the remnant church and the true believers, and they will be the multitude clothed in white, a peaceable multitude that will be raptured into paradise. But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt. Here is understanding required. They took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen, this is what? That they would leave the world and Babylon and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt. That is, they are moving now towards Mount Zion, wherever that Mount Zion will be. Nobody will know until it comes down. But they will move forward in the great Exodus to a further country where never mankind dwelt. They want to go into paradise, into the rapture, that they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land. Yes, because we are all sinners. We are all falling short of the glory. But now if we go into paradise, we will keep the statutes. And they entered into Euphrates by a narrow place of the river. This is another explanation for the great Exodus. For the Most High then showed signs for them, and held still the flood till they were passed over. For through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half, and the same region is called Azareth. And this Azareth will be the place where Mount Zion is, where paradise will be. And we will be taken there. We will walk there, and we will be taken there, and we will be guided there to reach that place to be raptured into paradise. Then dwell they there until the latter time. Listen to it, people. Then dwell they there until the latter time. And the latter time is the millennium. And now, when they shall begin to come. Now is the time when she should start now to come forward. The highest shall stay the springs of the stream again, that they may go through. Therefore sowest you the multitude with peace, the multitude clothed in white. But those that be left behind of your people are they that are found within my borders. Now when he destroyed the multitude of the nations that had gathered together against him, he shall defend his people that remain. This is the trumpet period. There is still a harvest to come. And then shall he show them great wonders through the 144,000. The trumpet period. Then said I, O Lord, that bearest rule, shew me this. Wherefore have I seen the man coming up from the midst of the sea? And he said unto me, like as you canst neither seek out nor know the things that are in the deep of the sea, even so can no man upon earth see my son, or those that be with him, but in the daytime. In the daytime, that's the day of his coming with Mount Zion. This is the day of his coming. Also later again, when he comes to Mount Olives. This is the interpretation of the dream which you saw, and whereby you only are here lightened. For you have forsaken your own way and applied true diligence unto my law and sought it. Your life hath you ordered in wisdom, and has called understanding your mother. And therefore have I showed you the treasures of highest. After other 3 days I will speak other things unto you, and declare unto you mighty and wondrous things. Then went I forth into the field, giving praise and thanks greatly unto the Most High, because of his wonders which he did in time, and because he governed the same and such things as fall in their season. And there I sat 3 days. You see? This is a total confirmation of Mount Zion, the gathering of the multitude clothed in white, the coming out into the Exodus, going to paradise, a place that we do not know where it will be yet, but will be shown when Jesus will come and the one who sits on the throne with the mountain not carved by human hand down for everybody to see. Be part of that multitude clothed in white. Be part of Triple Grace. Be part of this movement. Be part of Societies of the Rose. Be part of an assembly of love and righteousness. You can become an elder, a state leader, a national leader in your country. And you can establish Societies of the Rose in your places. And you can gather the saints and the people into righteousness in your neighborhood. Just start. If you have questions, ask your question at our ministry email, triplegrace55@gmail.com. How many more confirmations from the scriptures do you need to understand that our ministry is addicted to the gathering of the saints, to bring as many people to righteousness as possible, as written in Daniel 12:3, so that we then can be raptured into paradise and receive our spiritual mansion on Mount Zion, as it is written in John 14:2, the place is prepared by Jesus for us. Let us praise our Father Yahweh, and let us praise Jesus Christ for all his mercy and the time that he has given us. But now the time has come to step out of the world, to leave the place of the heathen, as it is written in 2 Esther, to come out of the world and out of Babylon and walk that path towards the holy mountain. Be part of it. Join triple/grace.com. It's free. Use our resources at YouTube. Become a subscriber, a member. Ask your questions. Start your own assembly of love and righteousness, your society of the rose in your neighborhood, wherever you are, no matter which country, which continent, it doesn't matter. Just come forth now. The time has come to show your glory and to let your light shine into your neighborhoods and into the nations for all to see, so that we can bring more and more people to righteousness, that we will have a multitude clothed in white that nobody can number at the base of Mount Zion. And you can be part of it. Become an elder, a state leader, a national leader, and bring the people to righteousness through spreading the word and walking the way of our Lord and Savior and King of the Millennium, Jesus Christ. Thank you that you have listened to this word today. Please consider. Consider to become a follower of the path, a daily sacrificer who will go out every day to lift up the needy. Let your light shine. Do more than only reading Bible verses and listen to sermons. Step out. Become a true and early Christian. Share resources, support one another. Do righteous deeds every day, because the righteous deeds of the saints will give you the white garment you need to enter paradise. Be part of Triple Grace. Join me, walk with me together, in love, unity and support. Thank you. And please also consider to support our children mission to Cambodia, where we will help poor children in education and in counseling if they were falling under violence or even rape. So help us. Everybody can do a little bit. I will put the Jesus and the Children Week for donation into the first pinned comment. So help us and send your love and your help for these poor little children. Even Jesus loves them so much. Thank you. Thank you for your help. Thank you that you sow into the children to give them a future. My name is Michael. I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation, and I hope you're watching my videos, especially the videos yesterday about facing the truth. And please also take the challenge of a pure heart. The links are all in the first pinned comment. So allow us to go forth with your mercy and with your help, with your support, with your donations, to lift up the small children onto the arms of Jesus Christ. Thank you. May God bless you and your family abundantly, and have a great day. And I hope I will see you again tomorrow. Maranatha.